The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 10, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 1st of November, 1976, in Vrindavan, India.
Sri Guru Mai Bhaktyan Vritya Vitishnaya Danda Titiksayasa Sadvatra Janta Babasa Vasanabhagatya Jihasaya Tamasa Iha Nivitya. So, this is called regulative means. In the previous verse, it was recommended that karmanuvaddha dhira asrateta. This attachment, karmanuvaddha, this material world, everyone is busy. We have discussed many times from morning to till late at night, and night also. They are busy, big factories, they are working day and night, one shift or the other shift. That has become the criterion of civilization. Formerly, it was less because this ugra karma, this factories means ugra karma, unnecessarily severe, hard work, unnecessary. We have seen in Detroit, they are manufacturing one farm, simply wheels of the motor, huge star wheels. And somebody is manufacturing tire, huge stock tire, and they are giving estimate, up till now so many millions of tire we have manufactured. Well, you know all this is in your country. And then there are so many motor parts, there are 3,000 small parts. The big factories are working to manufacture the parts of the motor car, different parts of the motor car, day and night working. And ultimately, they are preparing one car, and people are using huge quantity of cars. This is called karmanuvaddha, unnecessary. Ugra karma. Transportation is required. But we see from Krishna book that the inhabitants of Gokula, there was a meeting headed by Nanda Maharaj's young brother Upananda, and all the villagers, they assembled together. They discussed that our Krishna is being repeatedly attacked by the asuras, and it has become very troublesome. So let us leave this place. Their villagers, they thought it wise that because we are in this village, some of the demons are coming and disturbing. So their villagers, immediately Nanda Maharaj agreed, all right, let us leave this place. So immediately they transferred the whole village with their possession, cloth or something, everything, within 1 hour. And they transported by the bullock cart to Nandagram. That means the idea is the whole village was transferred from one village to another within a very short time. So the transport is required, the transport by bullock carts. The bulls are there, they can be used for transport, or the asses, they can be used for transport, and the camels can be used for transport. There are so many animals. So advancement and big kings, royal families, they have got their transport service by keeping elephants and horses. You can get on the back of the horses and get yourself there. So nature's arrangement, God's arrangement is there. Transport is required in the human society, but you can utilize so many animals for your purpose. But at the present moment, Ugrakal, the transport is there, but they have manufactured the big buses for transport, big cars, and the animals, they are now killed and eat. That's all. This is civilization. This is civilization. Not to reduce the labor, but increase the labor. Therefore, they are called Ugrakal. Jagato Ahita. And that will create disastrous condition of the human society. This is discussed in Bhagavad Gita. So, our this simple living, we are introducing the simple living. I go to the village, have sufficient food grains and milk, and the experiment is successful in the Western countries, in New Vrindavan, in Philadelphia, in New Orleans. So now the leaders of European and American countries, they are threatened by this kind of civilization. If it is advanced, then where do you stand? The simple living. In Australia, one psychiatrist, he remarked that if this kind of simple living is introduced, then where do you stand? So they want Ugrakal. They want to work day and night in the factories and to pacify themselves. They immediately require drinking, illicit sex, then by working on motor cars, they have no enough food, they want to eat meat, kill animals, and to digest the meat, he must drink one after another, one after another. So this Ugrakarma, they have introduced, but they are not happy. Because they are fools, they do not know. Their happiness is different. It cannot be had from the Ugrakarma. Therefore, here it is said, sarvatra basana jantat basana avagatya, sarvatra jantat basana avagatya. Your material civilization, wherever you advance materially, they disturb. Not only on this planet, but in other planets also. In the hard planet, there where they live for many millions of years, and their standard of happiness. Of course, these rascals, they are finding only stones and rocks in other planets. They have got everything only in this planet. And you have to believe. Wherever they are going, in the moon planet or in the Mars planet, what do they see? Simply rocks and sands. But that is not the fact. Each and every planet is full of living entities. Janakin, that is the statement in the... Everywhere, every planet, there are different kinds of living entities. Just like we see in this planet also, the Europeans are of different features, the Americans are different features, India different features, Africa different features. So, there are varieties of living entities, but no planet is vacant, that is not the fact. This is Ashkenda. They are declaring the planets are vacant, only their father's property here, that is full of living entities. This is nonsense. This is nonsense. Therefore, it is said, sarvatra janta vasana bhagatya. Sarvatra, everywhere, there are living entities. And there are sufferings. Not only living entities, as there are sufferings here, three kinds of miserable conditions, then that will continue. Abrahma bhuvana lokan punaravarti manti. That is statement of Krishna. Even if you go to the Brahmaloka, not that Brahmaloka is vacant. Why there are so many? Ananta koti planets, jasya prabhaha prabhavatu jagadanna koti. Not only one universe, but many millions and trillions of universes. Jasya prabhaha prabhavatu jagadanna koti kotisu asesu vasudhadi bhinnam. Kotisu, in each and every brahmanda, ananta vasudha. Vasudha means the living places. Vivinna ananta dasya prabhaha prabhavatu jagadanna koti kotisu asesu vasudhadi bhinnam. Bhinnam. The climatic, atmospheric position is different. Not that it is vacant. Bhinnam. Vasudhadi bhinnam. It is moon planet. That atmosphere is different. Otherwise, how it is possible that the moon planet is so nice, soothing, rays is coming, and why not from the sun? The sun is differently constructed, a different rays. It is God's arrangement. In daytime, you require sunshine, and you become tired. That night time, very soon, moon sun, he becomes pacified, pleased, soothing. Why the sun and the moon, if they are vacant or something like that? They do not know. Vasudhadi bhinnam. Each and every planet is differently constituted. They do not know. These rascals are passing as scientists and simply giving this conclusion that every planet is full of dust and rocks. If dust and rocks, then why from the sunshine so much heat is coming, and why from the moonshine so soothing and pleasing sign is coming? These are sketches, you know, and they are passing as scientists. I call them directly rascals, simply, set of rascals. They have never gone to the moon planet. They do not know what are the different positions of the different planets. Simply, they are, cheating people to get good salary, that's all. And in the name of scientists. But you should know, from the Vedic literature, the position. You should know that each and every planet is full of different types of living entities. And in the higher priority system, the standard of living may be very, not maybe it is mentioned, thousands and thousands of times better than this planet. This is called Bhuloka, then Bhuvarloka, then Sarvaloka, Janaloka, Mahaloka, Tapaloka, Satyaloka, Brahmaloka. These are different higher planetary systems. And each loka, the standard of happiness, is thousand times better than the other. This is the proof. And Krishna says, Avarma Bhuvana Loka. And similarly down, there are different lokas, tal, akal, talatal, nital, patal, like that. This is the constitution. But here, Rishabdev said, say anywhere you go, the threefold miseries of material existence, that will continue. You cannot get through. Even Brahmaloka, the Brahma, he is subjected to death. He also undergo the principles of death, and what to speak of others. Nobody will exist here. Abrahma Pupanaluka and Puraravartinarjuna. So we should know that we are trying to improve our material condition. It doesn't matter. You are now a poor man, and by doing something you get, great amount of wealth. That does not mean that we're free from dangerous condition of life. That is not. Sarvat. Either in this planet or another planet or to this condition, that condition, the threefold miseries, adhyatmik, adhidaivik, adhidaivik, and adhibhautik, these miseries and janma mrityu jarabhyasi, Krishna says, janma mrityu jarabhyasi, dukkha dosha anudarsana. Krishna never says that within this universe, if you go to the heavenly planet, then you can avoid janma mrityu jarabhyasi. Never says. Nobody says. Krishna says, even if you go to the heavenly planet, abrahma bhuvana loka, the janma mrityu jarabhyasi, there it is. You cannot avoid. Jadgatyana nivartante tad dhamam paramam vama. But if you come to me, paramdham, then you can avoid. Dukkhalayam asasvatam. Here, everywhere you will find dukkhalayam asasvatam. Just I was reading last night that Brihaspati's wife is kidnapped by Chandra. The Brihaspati is the spiritual master of the demigods, and his wife was kidnapped by Chandra. He is also one of the demigods. Just see, the sex and lusty desires are so strong even in the higher planetary system. And that is the cause. That is the cause. Here it is said, lingam vapohit kusalo homakhyam. This false ego is the cause of our miserable condition in this material world. Material world is miserable. Dukkhalayam asasvatam. This material world. One ant is living, say, for one day, and I am living for 100 years, and Brahma is living for millions of years. That does not mean any one of us is free from the miserable condition of this material. Nobody. Therefore, this material world is called dukkhalayam asasvatam. Māmupetra kaunteya dukkhālayam asāsvatam nā pūjanti mahātmānam saṃsiddhīn paramātmānam. That is saṃsiddhī, that if you become able how to become free from this encasement of material body, lingam bapo, therefore the endeavor should be how to give up this material body and be situated in our spiritual status, and that will give us. So for that, there are so many practices, regulative principles mentioned here. The first thing is, hamse guru mai bhaktanu mritya. This is adho gurbhasana. If you do not get a qualified guru, then everything is bogus. If you buy good fortune, if you get the association of a guru, qualified hamsa, paramhamsa. Paramhamsa guru means sannyasi's last stage is paramhamsa. Kutichav, bahujav, paribrajagacharya and paramhamsa. These are the different stages. When one takes sannyas, he lives outside the village in a kuti, in a cottage, and the family members goes and delivers him the food, because he is not practiced. So in the beginning, he keeps up this association of neighborhood, of family, but he is not practiced. He therefore lives outside the village, and if somebody gives some food, he eats. Then when he becomes experienced, then he does not accept food from one, either his own home or one home. He takes foodstuff from many homes. Give me a little piece of chapati. So somebody gives half, because they are also not overburdened. If they have to deliver so many sannyasis, come, and sumptuous food, then how the Jesus will provide? Therefore, though they do not overburden, there may be other sannyasis, therefore little one. Madhupuri. The Goswamis practice this Madhupuri in Vrindavan. They live, but they will take little only from the house. This is called Bahuga. Then when he is practiced more, he travels all over the world. Paribrajagacharya. And when he is fully experienced, then in spiritual life and everything, then he is Paramahamsa. So one must find out a guru who is Paramahamsa. Neither Kutichap nor Bahujap nor Kutbrah. Paramahamsa. So in the Chaitanya Charitamrita also, Lord Chaitanya says, Guru Krishna kripaya paya bhakti rata bij. This bhakti rata bij can be obtained through the mercy of Guru and Krishna. Here, Vishabdev is incarnation of Krishna. Therefore it says, mai, hamse guru mai. You cannot jump over Krishna. I know Krishna, I shall go to Krishna directly without guru. There are many rascals, they say like that. No, that is not possible. First of all guru, then Krishna. Hamse guru mai. Bhaktanu mitya. So these are descriptions, this is the beginning. If we actually practice the description and the prescription given in the Shastra, then it will be possible that, as it is said, karmanubhadya dirha asrathita, then our strong desire to enjoy this material world in different way, that will be slack. That is not. Thank you very much.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 16, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. recorded on the 4th of November, 1976, in Vrindavan, India.
Lokasyam Sreyasi Nasta Dishti Jo Arthan Samihita Nikama Kama Ananna Vaira Sukalesa Hetu Rananta Dukhamcha Nabhidam Vira. This is the description of the material world. Ananna Vaira, simply envious of one another. This is material. I am envious of you, you are envious of me. You can extend this family-wise, society-wise, community-wise, national-wise, but the basic principle is enviousness, nothing. Therefore, in the beginning of the Srimadha Bhagavatam, it is explained that who are fit for accepting this Bhagavat principle? Dharma prudhita koitava atra paramanirma saranam. This is meant for the persons who are no more envious. For them, those who are envious, they have no entrance in the principles of Srimadha Bhagavatam. Paramanimas, because the whole world is based on the principle of enviousness. Ananna Vaira. And what is the meaning of this enviousness? Sukhalesa Hetu, temporary happiness. Temporary happiness. Now, especially the modern world, not only modern world, always, that is the nature of this material world, how much fighting is going on between nation to nation, person to person, community to community. There are so many courts, legal courts. The people go there, fight with one another. Then the United Nations, what is that United Nations? I have already explained many times. Assembly of Barking Dogs, that's all. United. They will never unite. They go there and barking. Many times we are saying your enviousness. Krishna says that sarva-loka-mayasaram, I am the proprietor of all planets. But we are claiming this is my country. It is India, my country. This is Pakistan. This is America. This is Russia. And fight. The proprietor is there. He is claiming that this is not yours. It is mine. He's still there. Because why? Rananta dukkham cha navedumura. Rascals. He has no right. Unnecessarily, he or they are claiming right and fight. You have to do it because we are placed in a condition of suffering. Devi desha gunamai mamo maya dvartala. I have given this example many times. That's why in school, the teacher engages two naughty boys to catch the ears of one another. And he is pulling the ear, he is also pulling the ear. There is competition of pulling the ear. So nature engages them. Jagato avhitaya, ugra karma. They have manufactured this Ugra-Karma world for the annihilation of this world. Russia has discovered the nuclear, nuclear weapons, and the Americans, they are finding out the opportunity to drop the bomb here and there, and everything will be destroyed. They do not know what is the aim of life. Simply, they are engaged in Ugra Karma and creating enmity, Ananna Vaira, Sukhale Sohe. Maya Sukhaya Bharamu Bhato Vimura. Prahlad Maharaja also said that Sochi Tata Vimukha Chetas. I am simply thinking of this rasta. Vimura, here it is said, Mura. And Prahlad Maharaja says, Vimura, Visheshuru, particularly Mura. Prahlad Maharaja, Vaishnava, he has no problem. A Vaishnava has no problem. Prahlad Maharaja says, I have no problem, my Lord, to Nisingadev. Naivod vidhi paro durattaya vaita dharmya. Tad vijja gayana maha amrita magna chitta. A devotee will be simply satisfied if he has got the opportunity of reading, reciting Srimad Bhagavatam anywhere, any part of the world, sitting down underneath the tree. One who has got education, he can read Srimad Bhagavatam. But if one has no education, he cannot read, still he has no problem. He can chant Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. So he can enjoy anywhere. There is a practical example in this connection. While Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was touring in the southern India, in the Ranganath temple, he saw one Brahmin. He was reading Bhagavad Gita. Many persons were coming and criticizing him. Well, Brahmin, how you are reading Bhagavad Gita? He did not reply. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu approached him and he saw the Brahmana was reading Bhagavad Gita and tears gliding down. So he could understand that here is a pure devotee. So he asked him, well, Brahmana, what you are reading? So he said, sir, I cannot read. I am illiterate. I cannot read what is Bhagavad Gita, especially Sanskrit. His neighbors were criticizing him. They knew that this Brahmana is illiterate and he is making a show of reading Bhagavad Gita. So they were criticizing. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he could understand that here is a pure devotee. So he asked him, what you are reading? He said frankly, sir, I cannot read. I have no education, illiterate. Then it appears that you are reading something. And if you are illiterate, why you are reading Bhagavad Gita? No, my Guru Maharaj said, he knew that I am illiterate. But still my Guru Maharaj said that you read every day the shlokas of Bhagavad Gita. So, on account of his order, although I do not know anything what is written there, I am trying to. Oh, that's very nice. You are carrying the order of your Guru Maharaj. But it appears that you are crying also. How you are crying if you cannot read? Yes, sir, that's it. Because as soon as I take this Bhagavad Gita in my hand, I see the picture that Arjuna is asking Krishna to place his chariot in the war field, and Krishna is driving the chariot by his order. So this is creating some feeling in me. Oh, Krishna is so kind, so nice, that although he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is carrying the order of his devotee, a servant. When I feel this, I cry, ah, how Krishna is kind, how Krishna is merciful. So immediately Chaitanya Mahaprabhu embraced him. You are reading. It is not the literacy or education or knowing grammar and putting jugglery of words. That is not reading. If one feels what is the purport of Bhagavad Gita, that is reading Bhagavad Gita. It does not depend on literary kriya. A devotee is simply satisfied if he can think of Krishna. Krishna wants that. Manmana bhavam bhakta madhya dhima namaskar. Krishna never says that you become a great pandit or grammarian to read Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam. That if you can, if you have, you can. Otherwise, anyone, even a child, can do this. Manmana bhavam bhakta madhya dhima namaskar. One can come into this temple and offer obeisance. That will also do. Therefore, a devotee can be satisfied in any condition of life, provided he can think of Krishna's lotus feet. That's all. That much. Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj said that I have no problem. Nahi bodh vidhi paro gurutvaya. I have no problem to cross over the ocean of nisans. That solution is already there. Wherever I am, I shall think of your lotus feet. That's all. But you appear to be unhappy. Yes, I am unhappy. Why? Sote tato vimugacetasa. I am thinking of these rascals who have rejected your instruction in the Bhagavad Gita. Roche tato vimukacetasa, and they are busy. Like monkeys and dogs, they are busy. You see, they are very busy, going here, going there, going there, just like monkeys jumping from one tree to another, jumping wherever he is standing, he move his iron and everything. But people know that here is a monkey, he may appear to be very busy. People will immediately take his tail. Go away, go away, go away, go away. So our business is like that. We are making big, big plans to be happy like the monkeys. Therefore here it is said that arthana samiheta nikama kama. So it is the duty of everyone to do something for his welfare. But here in the beginning is loka svayam sriyasi nastu drishti. These rascals, they are blind to their real interest. Sriyas means real interest, and prayas means immediate profit. So, nikama kama, sense gratification is very nice immediately. I enjoy sex life, Nice. Why shall I chant Hare Krishna? Let me enjoy sex, Shreyasi and Prayasi. This is pleasure. And it is not pleasure. Therefore, Nostradristi, he does not know that this sense pleasure is not his actual pleasure, it is creating different types of miserable conditions. Nostradristi, he has no eyes. Arthan Sami Nikam Kaam, the Vishnu. He does not know either it is legal sex or illegal sex. There are two kinds of sex life, legal and illegal. Legal is married life sex, that is technically legal. And without marriage, like cats and dogs in this state or here and there, and that is illegal. The legal sex life is still allowed. Just like Krishna says, dharma viruddha kamosmi. If there is legal sex, one man and woman married, and only for progeny they get into sex life, that is allowed in this ashram. But illegal, illicit sex is most abominable. But either illicit or legal, there are so many sufferings, so many sufferings. Illegal, now they are giving opportunity, abortion, killing the child and so on, go to the hospital. That is also, and behind that, killing the child, very sinful, he has to suffer. He does not know. Ananta dukkha cha naveda mura. He is taking the risk of suffering life after life. Those who are killing the child in the womb, they will be punished. They will also enter within the womb of the mother and somebody will kill. And again he will enter another mother's womb. Again he will be killed. As many child he has killed, he has to go through the womb of the mother to another womb, another. He will never see the light of the world. He will be killed. This is the punishment. This is the punishment. But he does not know. Ananta dukkham cha naveda mura. He does not know how the laws of nature is working, life for life. You have no right to kill any life. Even an ant you cannot kill. You cannot kill. If you kill, then you have to suffer. These are not stories. These are not stories. There are many incidences in the Shastra, just like Vidura. He was Jamaraj, incarnation of Jamaraj, but he was cursed by Muni to become a Sudra. Why? Now, one Muni was brought in the court here, in the court of Jamaraj, and he was to be punished by light punishment, Shura, piercing the lancet through the rectum and it will come out. So the Muni asked Jamaraj, why you have put me into this tribulation, this punishment? What is my fault? The Jamaraj explained that in your childhood you pierced with a nail through the rectum of an ant. Therefore you must be punished like this. Let's see. In childhood playing, he pierced, sometimes you have seen the children do that. That is also counted. You cannot do any harm to any animal, any living being. You cannot do. But these rascals are regularly killing. Although they have got this human form of body, although they have got intelligence, scientific intelligence and so forth, but they do not know how nature's law is working. They do not care to. They say these are all mythology. Well, that's mythology. It is not mythology. Navedamura. They do not know what is the law of nature. They are ananta dukkha. So we should be very, very careful. We are implicating step by step. Padana padana jada vipada. They do not know. This material world means at every step we are creating another difficulty. Padana padana jada vipada. This material world where there is danger in every step, it is not possible. It is not. Therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has warned that niskinchanasya bhagavata bhajanonukasya. Anyone who is desirous of rendering such dedicates life for the service of Bhagavan Krishna. Krishna demands that. Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam bhaja. All such persons, one who has decided, yes, I shall fully surrender to Krishna. For such persons, niskinchana. Surrender means he has finished his own material business. No more business. That is called niskinchana. Kinchana means something. And niskinchana means that something also not. Annavilasita sunnam. Jnana karma dhanamritam. There are so many achievements by karma, jnana, yoga, so many things. But bhakti means finish this, all this nonsense business, karma, jnana, yoga. Simply surrender to Krishna. Anukullena Krishna anusiliram. So first such person, that is niskinchana. Atosar chari haiya niskinchana. Ekanta bhave raya Krishna ikasara and Chaitanya Chaitanya. So we have to become niskincha. No more material business. No more. That is called niskincha nasa. Who can take this niskincha? Bhagavad bhajana mukasya. Unless one is eager to serve the Lord, nobody can be niskincha. Everyone will have kincha. It's something mine, something mine, something mine. The first such person, niskinchanasya bhagavan bhajanam bhagasya, param param jirim subhu bhavasagarasya. Why? Bhagavad bhajan is required. Yes, it is most essential. Shreya. Shreyasi nastudist, you do not know. Krishna says that if you do not come to me, if you do not accept me, then nivartante mitru samsara vatmani. You will continue the cycle of birth and death, and that means ananta dukkham, ananta dukkham, one life after one life. This is gone. So we should be very, very careful that this human form of life should not be wasted, even for a moment. That is real life. That is by one shloka, by Rupa Goswami, abhartha kalakam. A devotee should always be alert to see whether this time, one moment passed, whether I have wasted it or I have utilized it. And that is, should be the point. Ayusha khala vidyam, khana eko nalambha sarna koti hi. This is also material estimation, that one moment of her life cannot be returned in exchange of millions of dollars, in from material point of view. And those who are advancing in spiritual life, how much careful they should be. Therefore, Rupa Goswami has given the formula, abhartha kalakam, not a single moment may be wasted without chanting Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 17, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 5th of November, 1976, in Vrindavan, India.
Kastanga sayangatara vigya vipasti abhidvayam antare vartamaram दृष्ट्या पुनस्तं सघनक बुद्धि प्रयोजयेत् पथवं आनम. सो वन पर्सन इज उत्पथवं यथा अंधम. अनदर पर्सन इज विपस्ति तद विज्ञ. Two classes of men, generally. One who knows the things as they are, and one who does not know what is the value of life, how to make progress. So one does not know and one knows. So naturally, there must be two classes of men. To make real social progress or anything. Actually we see that there are a class of men in the school, colleges, universities, who can teach, and class of men who are taught. So without these two classes of men, our society can make progress. But the modern theory is classless society. Modern rascal theory is classless society. There is no need of teacher, or there is no need of higher class, or there is no need of one class. Therefore, the fall down. Even in socialistic country like Russia, first of all they wanted to make classless society. Later on, they have made a manager class and worker class. Because this is not possible. If you want to manage things, there must be two classes of men. And two classes can be divided into so many other classes. Therefore, the intelligent way of civilization is described in the Bhagavad Gita, Chaturvarnamaya system, Gunakarma Vibhavas. There must be four classes. In order to manage things very nicely, you cannot make classless society. Four classes, the most intelligent class, Brahmana, and then next intelligent, the Kshatriyas, and the next intelligent, the Vaishyas, and the last one who has no intelligence, Shudra. These four classes must be there. Without this division of classes, society will guide them. At the present moment, without any class, the government has made adult vote. Anyone who is above certain age, say 18 years or 20 years, he can vote. But there is no class. This class can vote, this class cannot vote. There is no such thing. Anyone who is above 18 years old, he is competent to cast his vote. And people are not educated, in this division, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, they're all classless. Classless means fools, rascals, Shudra. If you classify means here is intelligent class, here is next class, here is next. If you don't classify, then means Shudra. So Shudras, they have got bhogs. Similarly, what they will elect? They will elect another rascal, that's all. Big rascal. A small rascal and big rascal, that's all. Therefore, in the Bhagavad it is said, Sabir Varaha Ustrakharai Sanstuta Purusha Poshuk. Here is our president, here is our prime minister. But what is he? He is elected by the Shudra, so he is a big Shudra, that's all. How can you expect nice things? If you say, now he is elected president, he is so much honored, and exalted post, His Excellency.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 10, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 1st of November, 1976, in Vrindavan, India.
Sri Guru Mai Bhaktyan Vitya Vitishnaya Danda titikshayacha sadvatra janta babasa vasanabhagatya jihasaya tamasa iha nivitya. So, this is called regulative means. In the previous verse, it was recommended that karmanuvaddha dhira asrakita. This attachment, karmanuvaddha, this material world, everyone is busy. We have discussed many times from morning to till late at night, and night also. They are busy, big factories, they are working day and night, one shift or the other shift. That has become the criterion of civilization. Formerly, it was less because this ugra karma. This factories means ugra karma. Unnecessarily severe, hard work, unnecessary. We have seen in Detroit, they are manufacturing one farm, simply wheels of the motor. Huge star wheels. And somebody is manufacturing tire, huge stock of tire, and they are giving estimate, up till now so many millions of tire we are manufacturing. You know all this is in your country. And then there are so many motor parts, there are 3,000 small parts. The big factories are working, to manufacture the parts of the motor car, different parts of the motor car, day and night working. And ultimately, they are preparing one car, and people are using huge quantity of cars. This is called karmanuvagya, unnecessary, ugragarma. Transportation is required, but we see from Krishna book that the inhabitants of Gokula, there was a meeting headed by Nanda Maharaj's young brother Upananda, and all the villagers, they assembled together. They discussed that our Krishna is being repeatedly attacked by the Asuras, and it has become very troublesome, so let us leave this place. Their villagers, they thought it wise that because we are in this village, some of the demons are coming and disturbing. So their villagers, immediately Nanda Maharaj agreed, all right, let us leave this place. So immediately they transferred the whole village with their possession, cloth or something, everything, within 1 hour. And they transported by the bullock cart to Nandagram. That means the idea is the whole village was transferred from one village to another within very short time. So the transport is required, the transport by bullock carts, the bulls are there, they can be used for transport, or the asses, they can be used for transport, and the camels can be used for transport. There are so many animals, so advancement and big kings, royal families, they have got their transport service by keeping elephants and horses. You can get on the back of the horses and get yourself there. So nature's arrangement, God's arrangement is there. Transport is required in the human society, but you can utilize so many animals for your purpose. But at the present moment, ugrakarma. The transport is there, but they have manufactured big buses for transport, big cars, and the animals, they are now killed and eat. That's all. This is civilization. This is civilization. Not to reduce the labor, but increase the labor. Therefore, ugrakarma. Jagato ahita. And that will create disastrous condition of the human society. This is discussed in Bhagavad Gita. So, our this simple living, we are introducing the simple living. I go to the village, have sufficient food grains and milk, and the experiment is successful in the Western countries, in New Vrindavan, in Philadelphia, in New Orleans. So now the leaders of European and American countries, they are threatened this kind of civilization. If it is advanced, then where do you stand? The simple living. In Australia, one psychiatrist, he remarked that if this kind of simple living is introduced, then where you stand? So they want Ugrakarma. They want to work day and night in the factories and to pacify themselves. They immediately require drinking, illicit sex, then by working on motor cars, they have no enough food, they want to eat meat, kill animals, and to digest the meat, he must drink one after another. So this Ugrakarma they have introduced, but they are not happy. Because they are fools, they do not know. Their happiness is different. It cannot be had from the Ugrakarma. Therefore, here it is said, sarvatra basana jantat basana avagatya. Sarvatra jantat basana avagatya. Your material civilization, wherever you advance materially, they disturb. Not only on this planet, but in other planets also, in the hard planet, there where they live for many millions of years, and their standard of happiness, of course these rascals, they are finding only stones and rocks in other planets. They have got everything only in this planet. And you have to believe. Wherever they are going, in the moon planet or in the Mars planet, what do they see? Simply rocks and sands. But that is not the fact. Each and every planet is full of living entities. Janakin, that is the statement in the... Everywhere, every planet, there are different kinds of living entities. Just like we see in this planet also, the Europeans are of different features, the Americans are different features, India different features, Africa different features. So there are varieties of living entities, but no planet is vacant, that is not the fact. This is Ashkenda. They are declaring the planets are vacant, only their father's poverty here, that is full of living entities. This is nonsense. This is nonsense. Therefore it is said, sarvatra jantat basana avagatya. Sarvatra, anywhere, there are living entities. And there are sufferings. Not only living entities, as there are sufferings here, three kinds of miserable condition. In that we will continue. Abrahma bhuvana lokan punaravartinati. That is statement of Krishna. Even if you go to the Brahma loka, not that Brahma loka is vacant. Why there are so many? Ananta koti planets. Jasya prabhaha prabhavatu jagadanna koti. Not only one universe, but many millions and trillions of universes. Jasya prabhaha prabhavatu jagadanna koti. Kotishu asesu vasudhadi bhinnam. Kotishu. In each and every brahmanda, ananta vasudhā. Vasudhā means the living places. Vivinna, ananta, dasya prabhā prabhavatu jagadanna koti, kotishu asesu vasudhādi bhinnam. Bhinnam. The climatic, atmospheric position is different. Not that it is vacant. Bhinnam. Vasudhādi bhinnam. It is moon planet. That atmosphere is different. Otherwise, how it is possible? that the moon planet, the so nice soothing rays is coming, and why not from the sun? The sun is differently constructed, a different rays. It is God's arrangement. In daytime you require sunshine and you become tired. That night time, very soon, moon sun, you become pacified, pleased, soothing. Why the sun and the moon, is there vacant or something like that? They do not know. Vasudhādi bhinnam. Each and every planet is differently constituted. They do not. These rascals are passing as scientists and simply giving this conclusion that every planet is full of dust and rocks. If dust and rocks, then why from the sun side so much heat is coming and why from the moon side so soothing and pleasing sign is coming? These are sketches, you know, and they are passing as scientists. I call them directly rascals, simply. Set of rascals. They have never gone to the moon planet. They do not know what are the different position of the different planets. Simply, they are, cheating people to get good salary, that's all. And in the name of scientists. But you should know from the Vedic literature the position. You should know that each and every planet is full of different types of living entities, and in the higher planetary system, the standard of living may be very, not maybe it is mentioned, thousands and thousands of times better than this planet. This is called Bhuloka, then Bhuvarloka, then Sarvaloka, Janaloka, Mahaloka, Tapaloka, Satyaloka, Brahmaloka. These are different higher planetary systems. And each loka, the standard of happiness, is thousand times better than the other. This is the position. And Krishna says, Avarma Bhuvana Loka. And similarly down, there are different lokas, tal, akal, talatal, nital, patal, like that. This is the constitution. But here, Rishabdev said, say anywhere you go, the threefold miseries of material existence, that will continue. You cannot get it. Even Brahma Loka, the Brahma, he is subjected to death. He also undergo the principles of death, and what to speak of others. Nobody will exist here. Abrahma Pupana Lokan Puraravartinatura. So we should know that we are trying to improve our material condition. It doesn't matter. You are now a poor man, and by doing something you get, great amount of wealth. That does not mean that we are free from dangerous condition of life. That is not. Sarvat, either in this planet or another planet or to this condition, that condition, the threefold miseries, adhyatmik, adhidaivik, adhidaivik, and adhibhautik, these miseries and janma mrityu jarabhyadhi, Krishna says, janma mrityu jarabhyadhi, dukkha dosha anudarsana. Krishna never says that within this universe, if you go to the heavenly planet, then you can avoid janma mrityu jarabhyadhi. Never says. Nobody says. Krishna says, even you go to the heavenly planet, Abrahma Bhuvana Loka, the janma mrityu jarabhyadhi, there it is. You cannot avoid. Jagatyana nivartante tad dhamam paramam mama. But if you come to me, Paramdham, then you can avoid. Dukkhalayam asāsvatam Here, everywhere, we find Dukkhalama Sahasranam. Just I was reading last night that Brihaspati's wife is kidnapped by Chandra. The Brihaspati is the spiritual master of the demigods, and his wife was kidnapped by Chandra. He is also one of the demigods. Just see, the sex and lusty desires are so strong even in the higher planetary system. And that is the cause. That is the cause. Here it is said, Lingam Bapohit Kusalo Homakyam. This false ego is the cause of our miserable condition in this material world. Material world is miserable. Dukkhalayam Asasatam. This material world. One ant is living, say, for one day, and I am living for 100 years, and Brahma is living for millions of years. That does not mean any one of us is free from the miserable condition of this material. Nobody. Therefore, this material world is called Dukkhalayam Asasatam. Mam peta kaunteya dukkhalayam asasatam na bhujanti mahatmanam samsiddhim paramatmata. That is samsiddhi, that if you become able how to become free from this encasement of material body, lingam bapohet, therefore the endeavor should be how to give up this material body and be situated in our spiritual status, and that will give us. So for that, there are so many practices, regulative principles, mentioned here. The first thing is, Hamse Guru Mai Bhaktanu Vritya. This is Adho Gurbhasana. If you do not get a qualified guru, then everything is bogus. If you buy good fortune, if you get the association of a guru, qualified hamsa, paramhamsa. Paramhamsa guru means sannyasi's last stage is paramhamsa. Kutichav, bahujav, paribrajagacharya and paramhamsa. These are the different stages. When one takes sannyas, he lives outside the village in a kuti, in a cottage, and the family members goes and delivers him the food, because he is not practiced. So in the beginning, he keeps up this association of neighborhood, of family, but he is not practiced. He therefore lives outside the village, and if somebody gives some food, he eats. Then when he becomes experienced, then he does not accept food from one, either his own home or one home. He takes foodstuff from many homes. Give me a little piece of chapati. So somebody gives half, because they are also not overburdened. If they have to deliver so many sannyasis, come and sumptuous food, then how the Jesus will provide? Therefore, though they do not overburden, there may be other sannyasis, therefore little on it. Madhupuri. The Goswamis practice this Madhupuri in Vrindavan. They live, but they will take little only from the house. This is called Bahudha. Then when he practice more, He travels all over the world for his Brajadacharya. And when he is fully experienced, then in spiritual life and everything, then he is Paramahamsa. So one must find out a guru who is Paramahamsa. Neither Kutichap nor Bahujap nor Kutbrah. Paramahamsa. So in the Chaitanya Charitamrita also Lord Chaitanya says, Guru Krishna Kripaya Paya Bhakti Rata Bij. This Bhakti Rata Bij can be obtained through the mercy of Guru and Krishna. So here, we saw that his incarnation of Krishna, therefore it says, Mai, Amsi Guru Mai. You cannot jump over Krishna. I know Krishna. I shall go to Krishna directly without Guru. There are many rascals, they say like that. No, that is not possible. First of all, Guru, then Krishna. Amsi Guru Mai. Bhaktana Vidya. So these are descriptions. This is the beginning. If we actually practice the description and the prescription given in the Shastra, then it will be possible that, as it is said, Karmanu Bhagya Dirha Asratita. Then our strong desire to enjoy this material world in different way, that will be slack. That is not. Thank you.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 16, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 4th of November, 1976, in Vrindavan, India.
Lokasyam sreyasi nasta dhisti jo arthan samihita nikama kama ananna vaira sukalesa hetu Rananta Dukhancha Nabhidamura. This is the description of the material world. Ananna Bhaira, simply envious of one another. This is material. I am envious of you, you are envious of me. You can extend this family-wise, society-wise, community-wise, national-wise. But the basic principle is enviousness, nothing. Therefore, in the beginning of the Srimadha Bhagavatam, it is explained that who are fit for accepting this Bhagavat principle. Dharma prudhita koitavatra paramanirmasaranam. This is meant for the persons who are no more envious. For them, those who are envious, they have no entrance in the principles of Srimadha Bhagavatam. Paramanimas, because the whole world is based on the principle of enviousness. Ananna vaira. And what is the meaning of this enviousness? Sukhalesa hetu, temporary happiness. Temporary happiness. Now, especially the modern world, not only modern world, always that is the nature of this material world, how much fighting is going on between nation to nation, person to person, community to community. There are so many courts, legal courts. The people go there, fight with one another. Then the United Nations, what is that United Nations? I've already explained many times. Assembly of barking dogs, that's all. United. They'll never unite. The Bhagavad says, yes, this is all good, but by whom he is praised? Savirivarahaustakharayu, samustuta purushapkosu. Just like lion. Lion is very strong animal. He is considered to be the king of the forest. So, all other small animals they are very much afraid of, very respectful. But does it mean, because he is lion, he is not an animal? He is an animal. He may be lion, very powerful, very strong, he can subdue others. But that does not mean he is any advanced, intelligent person like Brahmana, Kshatriya. This is good. The Bhagavad therefore says, Savirivaraha ustakharai samsuta purusa pushu. Anyone, if he is not Krishna conscious, he is a pushu. Anyway. Because human life is meant for that purpose. Tapo dibbama putra kajina suddheda sakta. Otherwise, he is animal. So this is going on at the present moment. Some small animal accepting one big animal as leader. So both of them, all of them are animals. But this is not social system. The social system, as Krishna says, chaturvarnamaya system. You cannot violate the laws given by Krishna, God. You must have. You must make training, just like you are training some men as engineers, some men as medical men, some men as lawyers, some men as technologists. There are so many divisions in the society. Therefore, similarly, if you want to make the human society perfect, then you must have these four classes of men. Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. Otherwise, there is no person. If you make all classes one, very liberal, very good idea, there is no classification. No, there must be class. But that classification is not by birth. That is not by birth. Guna karma vibhas. Krishna never said this classification should be by birth. No. Janmana jayate shuddha. By birth everyone is rasika and shuddha. That is to be accepted. Even if one is born in a Brahmin family, he is to be accepted as Shudra. Janmana, by birth. Otherwise, why if a person is born in a Brahmin family, he requires to be educated, he requires to be initiated, sacred thread, sanskarat bhavit vijo. There must be sanskara. If he is born Brahmana, then why there is no need of sanskara? There is no need of education. Suppose a person is born the son of high court judge. Does it mean that he is high court judge? No. He requires education. He requires training. But he has a good chance to become a high court judge. Because his father is high court judge, he knows how to train his son, how to educate him, how to become a lawyer, and he has got influence in government, society, he can recommend him. He has got the chance to become a high court judge. But not that because he is born of a father who is high court judge, therefore he is. That is good. A person born in Brahmana family, if the family is strictly following the Brahminical rules and regulations, in this Shastra it is said that in higher section, Brahman especially, if Gandharvan samskar is not observed, the whole family immediately becomes Shudra. He cannot be called even Brahman. That is in that sense. Samskara dhavidhija dasavidha samskara, that must be strictly observed, otherwise he is Shudra. Shudra has no samskara. Shudra has only one samskara, marriage. And the Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, they have got dasavidha samskara. Before birth, when the child is in the womb, there is ceremony. Then when he is born, there is ceremony. When he is little born, just like Parikshit Maharaj, when he was born, immediately all the Brahmins name Japakarma ceremony. A child is born, there will be some puja part, and then there will be horoscope made immediately. In what moment this child is born, what will be his feature? All the Brahmins made immediately horoscope. You'll find in this Bhagavata. This is called samskara. Not that like cats and dogs that are born without any samskara, and because he is born in a certain family, he becomes Brahman, Kshatriya. No. Yes. So, there must be a first-class man in the society, samo dhamo titikha. Where is that education and institution at the present moment? That here is a school where education is given how to become a Brahmin. This is Kali Yuga. Nobody will go. Nobody. If you start a school, I was thinking, now just like we are starting this Gurukulam, to train small children how to become Brahmachari. Brahmachari Gurukule Vasandanta Guru Hitam. But I am very doubtful whether people will send their children. Because before starting this movement, I wanted some boys from respectable family to give me your one son. I shall train him how to become Brahmana, how to become preacher. Nobody knew. They said, Swamiji, what they will be by becoming. Because they have seen the so-called Brahmin begging, no education, and there is no begging, then stealing, then cheating. Well, gentlemen see that this is Brahman in the society. You'll find in Vrindavan so-called Brahman Pandit, Pandas, no education, and they do everything, it is known to everyone. So because there is no training, in Pandas they were guiding the tourists or the visitors. They were trained as Brahmin Pandit. Now, practically, higher section of the society, they do not come. One gentleman asked me in Delhi in the beginning, hey, Swamiji, why you have made Vrindavan as your headquarters? Because they have got a very bad experience. So, in the Vrindavan city, you see how they are neglected. We are a little far off from the city. You go, how they are neglected city. No up-to-date gentleman can go there. Because the culture is lost. And from big Gosai's family, they are becoming rogues and thieves. Because training is not there. Training, the first class man to train them. So, therefore it is our little attempt that to train some boy to become first-class character, samadhamatitikha, that is required in the society. Simply all fourth-class, fifth-class men, how the society will improve, that is not possible. And therefore, kastam sānta vidgā vipaschi, avidyāyām antare vartamānam. And one who is actually educated in the Vedic knowledge, how he can say that you are all right? He cannot say. He gives chance for being trained to be free from the avidya. Avidyāyamantare. Sarīra avidya jāva. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has sung, Sarīra avidya jāva. This material body is a network of avidya, ignorance. Sarīra avidya jāva. Jarendriya tahe kā. On account of this body of avidya, ignorance, the blind senses are simply, they have been described sometimes as kāla-sattva. Kāla-sattva indriya-patali. Duddhānta indriya kāla-sattva patali. So, therefore, yoga system is recommended to control this kāla-sattva, the indriya. Yoga indriya-sattva. Real yoga, ordinary. Yoga. Nobody is getting that yoga siddhi, astra siddhi. Generally, the so-called yogis, they show some asana, dhyana, dharana, pranayama. But that is meant for controlling the senses. Yoga, indriya. Without sense control, nobody can make any progress in human life. Tapasya is called tapasya. So yoga is also another tapasya. Tapo, tapasya brahmacharyena. So any path you take, the brahmacharya first thing. Without brahmacharya, there is no question of tapasya. Tapasya brahmacharyena samena gamena va. Tyagena satta saucha bhyam jamena nyamena. This is usual. This is human life. Not that upstart, coolies, rascals, sudras, that is human society. That is dog society. That is not human society. Human society must be intelligent class of man. They will train the other people. Everything is required. The kshatriya is required, the vaishya is required, the sudra is also required. That's why it is given. In the shastra, to keep a fully equipped body, there must be head, there must be arm, there must be belly, there must be leg. Leg is also required. Not that simply brain is required. Brain is required to direct the leg. Go this way, go that way. And then in that sense, sudra is also, brain cannot walk. The leg will walk. So the brain will give direction, the hand will give protection, everything is required. Therefore we have named this Krishna consciousness society. Now society means all classes of men required. But we train them how to make life perfect. That is one. Not that one-sided, simply blind. That variety. This is called variety, not nirvishesha classes. No Brahman required, no Sudra required, no, everything is required. Everything is required, but they should be properly trained now. So one class man, first of all teacher, they require. Therefore, the Brahmin class must be there. I mean to say, the properly trained up Brahman, not by caste Brahmin. Or samadhamatitikha. Otherwise, where is the ideal class who will teach? And it is the business of Brahmana to teach. Those who are Shuddha, Avidyayamantare Vartamana, how they can teach? They cannot teach. Therefore, Brahman business is Pathan, Pathan, Jajan, Jajan, Dana, Pratigra. Six, Satkarma, Nipuna, Vipra. Mantra, Tantra, Vishara. Still, if he is not a Vaishnava, or Vaishnava, Guru, Nasasya, if one is qualified Brahmana, but Mantra, Tantra, Vishara, everything is well equipped, but if he is not a Vaishnava, if he is impersonalist, Mayavadi, he cannot teach. Avaishnava Guru Manasya. He cannot be Guru. Asad Vaishnava Sapacha Guru. And if a person born in a family of dog eaters, Sapacha, means Chandala, there are many kinds of meat eaters. So, the class of men who are dog eaters, they are the worst. They are the worst. Chandal. So, if a person born in a dog eater's family, he can be also trained up. Sat Vaishnava Sapato Guru. The Guru does not mean a dastar. A Sapacha, a person born in the family of Sapacha, he can be also trained up to become Vaishnava. That is also a claim by Krishna. Mahipatavasika Jivisu Pahurunaya. This person who is born in the Sapacha family, Chandala family, is called Papajoni. Joni means mother. And Bija means father. Bija may be nice. But if the Joni is not nice, that is called Varnasam. These are the things. Yathabhijam tathajam. They must be equally qualified. Anyway, so Papajani, born in the Umbape, low class Joni. But he can be trained. How? Manihi partham vapasitya. If he takes to Krishna consciousness, and he can be trained. There is no harm. Krishna says, Mani Partho Bhapasu. So, if you take shelter of Krishna's lotus feet, then we can become first class man. There is no doubt about it. Otherwise, Krishna says, Te Vijanti Parangati. Do you think Parangati is available for the third class, fourth class, last class man? No. Krishna says another place, these things have to be studied very minutely. Jisavantakatam pāpam, janānām puṇya-karmānām, te dandamahālu, bhavunām janmanāmante, jñāna-vānmāṁ prapaddhate. So one has become Vaishnava. Does it mean he is full steed? No. Training. Training is there. Otherwise, how Krishna recommends? Jīpīsū pāpa-yūna. To become high court judge, does it mean it is ordinary qualification? If you say that man has become high court judge, and the other man who has seen him before, that he is born, no, how he can become high court judge? No, he is born of a very low class family. No, he has become high court. No, I don't believe. No, I have seen him. This is possible. It is not that because one is born in low class family, he cannot become high court judge or he cannot become a Vaishnava. He can. So Sanatana Goswami recommends, Tathādikkhāvidhārena dvijattam jāyate nina. Tathādikkhāvidhārena. If dikkhāvidhāna initiation process is done nicely, from the right person. There are so many śāstras. Suddhanti, yadupāśraya-śraya, tirāta-hungārda-pudhinda-pukkasa, abhīra-sumbha-javanākhasāraya. Then means upāva. Jagupasraya Sraya Subhanti. These are things are there. So, by the disciplic succession, by the instruction of the Goswamis, everyone can be purified. Because they will properly train up. Avidya antare vartamana, they will not misguide. Drishtyatmastam sakuna kubuddhi. Mercy. Never mind. But there is no disqualification because one is low born and that. Everyone can take, but he must follow the direction of the proper guide. Just like we say, no meditating, no intoxication, no illicit sex. If you follow the rules and regulations and chant Hare Krishna under the guidance of proper spiritual master, then everything will be all right. He will no more Shudra or Chandal. He will become Chandala Vidyasastra, Vri Bhakti Parama. By advancing Krishna consciousness, he can be raised to the highest man. So, it is the duty of the guide not to engage him in lower class occupation. Therefore, there must be a class of men, first class, who can teach the society how to advance in human civilization. Thank you very much. Go there and bark in. Many times we have seen the enviousness. Krishna says that sarva-loka-maya-saram, I am the proprietor of all planets. But we are claiming this is my country. It is India, my country. This is Pakistan. This is America, this is Russia, empire. And the proprietor is there, he is claiming that this is not yours, it is mine. He is still there. Because why? Rananta dukkham ca navedumura. Rascals, he has no right. Unnecessarily, he or they are claiming right and fight. You have to do it because we are placed in a condition of suffering. Devidesha gunamai mamumaya jyotala. I have given this example many times. Last time in school, the teacher engages two naughty boys to catch the ears of one another. And he is pulling the ear, he is also pulling the ear. There is competition of pulling the ear. And nature engages them. Jagato hitaya, ugra karma. They have manufactured this ugra karma world for the annihilation of this world. Russia has discovered the nuclear, what is that? Nuclear weapons. And the Americans, they are finding out the opportunity so to drop the bomb here and there, and everything will be destroyed. They do not know what is the aim of life. Simply, they are engaged in ugra karma and creating enmity, ananna vaira, sukhale sade. Maya sukhaya bharamu bahato vimura. Prahlad Maharaj also said that sochi tato vimukha chetasu. I am simply thinking of this rascal. Vimura, here it is said, mura. And Prahlad Maharaj says, Vimuru, Visheshuru, particularly Mura. Prahlad Maharaj, Vaishnava, he has no problem. A Vaishnava has no problem. Prahlad Maharaj says, I have no problem, my Lord. to Nrisimhadev, Nilmud Vidhi Paro Gurutvaya Vaitaranya, Tad Vijjagayana Mahamrita Magna Chitta. A devotee will be simply satisfied if he has got the opportunity of reading, reciting Srimad Bhagavatam anywhere, any part of the world, sitting down underneath the tree. One who has got education, he can read Srimad Bhagavatam. But if one has no education, he cannot read. Still, he has no problem. He can chant Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. So he can enjoy anywhere. There is a practical example in this connection. While Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was touring in the southern India, in the Ranganath temple, he saw one Brahmin. He was reading Bhagavad Gita. Many persons were coming and criticizing him. "Well, Brahmin, how you are reading Bhagavad Gita?" He did not reply. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu approached him, and he saw the Brahmana was reading Bhagavad Gita and tears gliding down. So he could understand that here is a pure devotee. So he asked him, "Well, Brahmana, what you are reading?" So he said, "Sir, I cannot read. I am illiterate. I cannot read what is Bhagavad Gita, especially Sanskrit." He never started criticizing him. They knew that this Brahmana is illiterate and he is making a show of reading Bhagavad Gita. So they were criticizing. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he could understand that here is a pure devotee. So he asked him, "What you are reading?" He said frankly, "Sir, I cannot read. I have no education, illiterate." Then it appears that you are reading something. And if you are illiterate, why are you reading Bhagavad Gita? "No, my Guru Maharaj said, he knew that I am illiterate. But still my Guru Maharaj said that you read every day the shlokas of Bhagavad Gita. So on account of his order, although I do not know anything what is written there, I am trying to do." Oh, that's very nice. You are carrying the order of your Guru Maharaj. But it appears that you are crying also. How you are crying if you cannot read? "Yes, sir, that's it. Because as soon as I take this Bhagavad Gita in my hand, I see the picture that Arjuna is asking Krishna to place his chariot in the war field, and Krishna is driving the chariot by his order. So this is creating some feeling in me. Oh, Krishna is so kind, so nice, that although he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is carrying the order of his devotee, a servant. When I feel this, I cry. Ah, how Krishna is kind, how Krishna is merciful." So immediately Chaitanya Mahaprabhu embraced him. "You are reading. It is not the literacy or education or knowing grammar and putting jugglery of word. That is not really. If one feels what is the purport of Bhagavad Gita, that is reading Bhagavad Gita. He does not defend our literary career. A devotee is simply satisfied if he can think of Krishna. Krishna wants that. Manvana bhavam bhakta madhya jima namaskar. Krishna never says that he become a great pandit or grammarian to read Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam. That if you can, if you have, you can. Otherwise, anyone, even a child, can do this. Manmana bhavama bhakta madhya jima namaskar. One can come into this temple and offer obeisance. That will also do. Therefore, a devotee can be satisfied in any condition of life, provided he can think of Krishna's lotus feet, that's all. That much. Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj said that I have no problem. Naivodhviti paro gurutvaya. I have no problem to cross over the ocean of nisans. That solution is already there. Wherever I am, I shall think of your lotus feet, that's all. But you appear to be unhappy. Yes, I am unhappy. Why? Sote tato vimugo cetaso. I am thinking of these rascals who have rejected your instruction in the Bhagavad Gita. Sote tato vimugo cetaso, and they're busy. Like monkeys and dogs, they are busy. You see, they are very busy, going here, going there, going there, just like monkeys jumping from one tree to another, jumping wherever he is standing, he move his iron and everything. But people know that here is a monkey, he may appear to be very busy. People will immediately take his tail. Go out, go out, go out, go out. So our business is like that. We are making big, big plans to be happy like the monkeys. Therefore here it is said that arthana samiheta nikama kama. So it is the duty of everyone to do something for his welfare. But here in the beginning is loka svayam sriyasi nastu dhisti. These rascals, they are blind to their real interest. Sriyas means real interest. And prayas means immediate profit. So, nikama kama, sense gratification is very nice immediately. I enjoy sex life, this is very nice. Why shall I chant Hare Krishna? Let me enjoy sex, sriyasi and prayasi, and this is pleasure. And it is not pleasure. Therefore, nastu dhisti. He does not know that this sense pleasure is not his actual pleasure. It is creating different types of miserable conditions. Nastu dhisti, he has no eyes. Arthan samye nikama kama, the Vishnu. He does not know either it is legal sex or illegal sex. There are two kinds of sex life, legal and illegal. Legal is married life sex, that is taken as legal. And without marriage, like cats and dogs in the street or here and there, and that is illegal. So legal sex life is still allowed. Just like Krishna says, dharma viruddha kamosmi. If there is legal sex, one man and woman married, and only for progeny, they get into sex life. That is allowed in this ashram. But illegal, illicit sex is most abominable. But either illicit or legal, there are so many sufferings, so many sufferings. Illegal, now they are giving opportunity, abortion, killing the child and so on, so go to the hospital. That is also, and behind that, killing the child, very sinful, he has to suffer. He does not know. Ananta dukkha cha naveda mura. He is taking the risk of suffering life after life. Those who are killing the child in the womb, they will be punished. They will also enter within the womb of the mother and somebody will kill. And again he will enter another mother's womb. Again he will be killed. As many child he has killed, he has to go through the womb of the mother to another womb, another. He will never see the light of the world, he will be killed. This is the punishment. This is the punishment, but he does not know. Ananta dukkham cha naveda mura. He does not know how the laws of nature is working, life for life. You have no right to kill any life, even an ant you cannot kill. You cannot kill. If you kill, then you have to suffer. These are not stories. These are not stories. There are many incidences in the Shastra, just like Vidura. He was Jamaraj, incarnation of Jamaraj, but he was cursed by Muni to become a Shudra. Why? Now, one Muni was brought in the court here, in the court of Jamaraj, and he was to be punished by light punishment, Shudra, piercing the lancet through the rectum and it will come out. So the Muni asked Jamaraj, why you have put me into this tribulation, this punishment? What is my fault? The Jamaraj explained that in your childhood you pierced with a nail through the rectum of an ant. Therefore you must be punished like this. That's it. In childhood playing, he played, sometimes you have seen the children do that. That is also counted. You cannot do any harm to any animal, any living being. You cannot do. But these rascals are regularly killing. Although they have got this human form of body, although they have got intelligence, scientific intelligence and so forth, but they do not know how nature's law is working. They do not care to. They say these are all mythology. Well, that's mythology. It is not mythology. Naveda mura. They do not know what is the law of nature. They are ananta dukkha. So you should be very, very careful. We are implicating step by step, padana padana jada vipala. They do not know. This material world means at every step we are creating another difficulty. Padana padana jada vipala. This material world where there is danger in every step, it is not possible. It is not. Therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has warned that niskinchanasya bhagavata bhajanonukasya. Anyone who is desirous of rendering service, dedicates life for the service of Bhagavan Krishna. Krishna demands that. Sarva dharmān parityajya māmekam saraṇam bhaja. or Pasatpas, one who has decided, yes, I shall fully surrender to Krishna. For such person, nishchinchana. Surrender means he has finished his own material business. No more business. That is called nishchinchana. Kinchan means something. And nishchinchana means that something also not. Annavilasita sunno. Jnana karma dhanamritam. There are so many achievements by karma, jnana, yoga, so many things. But bhakti means finish this, all this nonsense business, karma, jnana, yoga. Simply surrender to Krishna. Anukullena Krishna anusiriram. So for such person, that is niskincha. Atosar chari haiya niskincha. Ekanta bhave raya krishnaika sara. Chaitanya Chaitanya. So we have to become niskincha. No more material business. No more. That is called niskincha nasa. Who can take this niskincha? Bhagavad bhajana unmukasya. Unless one is eager to serve the Lord, nobody can be niskincha. Everyone will have kincha. It's something mine, something mine, something mine. The first such person, niskinchanasya bhagavad bhajana unmukasya, parama parama jirimsu bhavasagarasya. Why? Bhagavad bhajana is required. Yes, it is most essential. Shreya. Shreyasi nastudist, you do not know. Krishna says that if you do not come to me, if you do not accept me, then nivartante mitru samsara vatmani. You will continue the cycle of birth and death, and that means ananta dukkham. Ananta dukkham. One life after one life. This will go on. So we should be very, very careful that this human form of life should not be wasted even for a moment. That is real life. That is by one sloka by Rupa Goswami. Abhartha-kalakam. A devotee should always be alert to see whether this time, one moment passed, whether I have wasted it or I have utilized it. And that is, should be the point. Ayusha khala vidyam khana eko nalabha sarna koti hi. This is also material estimation. That one moment of her life cannot be returned in exchange of millions of dollars. In from material point of view. And those who are advancing in spiritual life, how much careful they should be. Therefore, Rupa Goswami has given the formula, abhartha kalakam. Not a single moment may be wasted without chanting Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 17, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 5th of November, 1976, in Vrindavan, India.
Kastam sayanata vibhigya vipasti abhidyayam antare vartamaram drishtya punastam sabhinattu buddhi prayojayet patavam nāgnam. So, one person is utpathagam jathāvandham. Another person is vipasti tadabhigyam. Two classes of men, generally. One who knows the things as they are, and one who does not know what is the value of life, how to make progress. So one does not know and one knows. So naturally, there must be two classes of men. To make real social progress or anything, actually we see that there are a class of men in the school, colleges, universities, who can teach, and class of men who are taught. So without these two classes of men, our society can make progress. But the modern theory is classless society. Modern Russell theory is classless society. There is no need of teacher, or there is no need of higher class, or there is no need of one class. Therefore, the fall down. Even in socialistic country like Russia, first of all they wanted to make classless society. Later on, they have made a manager class and worker class. Because this is not possible. If you want to manage things, there must be two classes of men. And two classes can be divided into so many other classes. Therefore, the intelligent way of civilization is described in the Bhagavad Gita, Chaturvarnamaya system, Gunakarma Vibhavas. There must be four classes. In order to manage things very nicely, you cannot make classless society. Four classes, the most intelligent class, Brahmana, and then next intelligent, the Kshatriyas, and the next intelligent, the Vaishyas, and the last one who has no intelligence, Shudra. These four classes must be there. Without this division of classes, society will guide them. At the present moment, without any class, the government has made adult vote. Anyone who is above certain age, say 18 years or 20 years, he can vote. But there is no class. This class can vote, this class cannot vote. There is no such thing. Anyone who is above 18 years old, he is competent to cast his vote. And people are not educated in this division, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. They are all classless. Classless means fools, rascals, shudras. If you classify means here is intelligent class, here is next class, here is next. If you don't classify, then means shudra. So shudras, they have got votes. Similarly, what they will elect? They will elect another rascal, that's all. Big rascal. A small rascal and big rascal, that's all. Therefore, in the Bhagavad it is said, Savir Varaha Ustrakharai Samstuta Purusha Poshu. Here is our president, here is our prime minister, but what is he? He is elected by the Shudra, so he is a big Shudra, that's all. How can you expect nice things? If you say, now he is elected president, he is so much honored, and he exalted post, His Excellency.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 10, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 1st of November, 1976, in Vrindavan, India.
Sri Guru Mayi Bhaktyan Vritya Vitishnaya Danda Titiksaya Cha Sadvatra Janta Babasa Vasanabhagatya Jihasaya Tamasa Iha Nivitya. So, this is called regulative means. In the previous verse, it was recommended that karmanuvaddha dhira asrateta. This attachment, karmanuvaddha, this material world, everyone is busy. We have discussed many times from morning to till late at night, and night also. They are busy, big factories, they are working day and night, one shift or the other shift. And that has become the criterion of civilization. Formerly, it was less because this ugra karma, this factories means ugra karma. Unnecessarily severe, hard work, unnecessary. We have seen in Detroit, they are manufacturing one farm, simply wheels of the motor, huge star wheels. And somebody is manufacturing tire, huge stock tire, and they are giving estimate, up till now so many millions of tire we have manufactured. You know all these cities in your country. And then there are so many motor parts, there are 3,000 small parts. The big factories are working to manufacture the parts of the motor car, different parts of the motor car, day and night working. And ultimately, they are preparing one car, and people are using huge quantity of cars. This is called karmanuvaddha, unnecessary. Ugra karma. Transportation is required. But we see from Krishna book that the inhabitants of Gokula, there was a meeting headed by Nanda Maharaj's young brother Upananda. And all the villagers, they assembled together. They discussed that our Krishna is being repeatedly attacked by the Asuras, and it has become very troublesome. So let us leave this place. They are villagers. They thought it wise that because we are in this village, some of the demons are coming and disturbing. So they are villagers. Immediately Nanda Maharaj agreed, all right, let us leave this place. So immediately they transferred the whole village with their possession, cloth or something, everything, within 1 hour. And they transported by the bullock cart to Nandagram. That means the idea is the whole village was transferred from one village to another within very short time. So the transport is required, the transport by bullock carts. The bulls are there, and they can be used for transport, or the asses, they can be used for transport, and the camels can be used for transport. There are so many animals. So advancement and big kings, royal families, they have got their transport service by keeping elephants and horses. You can get on the back of the horses and get yourself there. So nature's arrangement, God's arrangement is there. Transport is required in the human society, but you can utilize so many animals for your purpose. But at the present moment, Ugrakal, the transport is there, but they have manufactured big buses for transport, big cars, and the animals, they are now killed and eat. That's all. This is civilization. This is civilization. Not to reduce the labor, but increase labor. Therefore, they are called Ugrakal. Jagato Ahita. And that will create disastrous condition of the human society. This is discussed in Bhagavad Gita. So, our this simple living, we are introducing the simple living. I go to the village, have sufficient food grains and milk, and the experiment is successful in the Western countries, in New Vrindavan, in Philadelphia, in New Orleans. So now the leaders of European and American countries, they are threatened by this kind of civilization. If it is advanced, then where do you stand? The simple living. In Australia, one psychiatrist, he remarked that if this kind of simple living is introduced, then where do you stand? So they want Ugrakal. They want to work day and night in the factories and to pacify themselves. They immediately require drinking, illicit sex, then by working on motor cars, they have no enough food, they want to eat meat, kill animals, and to digest the meat, he must drink one after another. So this Ugrakarma, they have introduced, but they are not happy. Because they are fools, they do not know. Their happiness is different. It cannot be had from the Ugrakarma. Therefore, here it is said, sarvatra basana janta basana avagatya. Sarvatra janta basana avagatya. Your material civilization, wherever you advance materially, there is trouble. Not only on this planet, but in other planets also, in the hard planet, there where they live for many millions of years, and their standard of happiness. Of course, these rascals, they are finding only stones and rocks in other planets. They have got everything only in this planet. And you have to believe. Wherever they are going, in the moon planet or in the Mars planet, what do they see? Simply rocks and sands. But that is not the fact. Each and every planet is full of living entities. Janakin, that is the statement in the everywhere, every planet, there are different kinds of living entities. Just like we see in this planet also, the Europeans are of different features, the Americans have different features, India different features, Africa different features. So there are varieties of living entities, but no planet is vacant, that is not the fact. This is Ashkelta. They are declaring the planets are vacant, only their father's property here, that is full of living entities. This is nonsense. This is nonsense. Therefore it is said, sarvatra jantam vasanavagatya. Sarvatra, anywhere, there are living entities and there are sufferings. Not only living entities, as there are sufferings here, three kinds of miserable condition, then that will continue. Abrahma bhuvana lokan punaravartinam. That is statement of Krishna. Even you go to the Brahma Loka, not that Brahma Loka is vacant. Why there are so many? Ananta koti planets. Jasya prabhaha prabhavatu jagadanna koti. Not only one universe, but many millions and trillions of universes. Jasya prabhaha prabhavatu jagadanna koti. Kotisu asesu vasudhadi bhinnam. Kotisu. In each and every brahmanda, ananta vasudha. Vasudha means the living places. Vivinna ananta jasya prabhaha prabhavatu jagadanna koti kotisu asesu vasudhadi bhinnam. Bhinnam. The climatic, atmospheric position is different. Not that it is vacant. Bhinnam. Vasudhadi bhinnam. It is moon planet. That atmosphere is different. Otherwise, how it is possible that the moon planet, the so nice soothing rays is coming, and why not from the sun? The sun is differently constructed, a different rays. It is God's arrangement. In daytime, you require sunshine, and you become tired. That night time, very soon, moon sun, he becomes pacified, pleased, soothing. Why the sun and the moon, if they are vacant or something like that? They do not know. Vasudhadi bhinnam. Each and every planet is differently constituted. They do not know. These rascals, they are passing as scientists and simply giving this conclusion that every planet is full of dust and rocks. If dust and rocks, then why from the sun side so much heat is coming, and why from the moon side so soothing and pleasing sign is coming? These are sketches, you know, and they are passing as scientists. I call them directly rascals, simply. Set of rascals. They have never gone to the moon planet. They do not know what are the different position of the different planets. Simply, they are, cheating people to get good salary, that's all. And in the name of scientists. But you should know, from the Vedic literature, the position. You should know that each and every planet is full of different types of living entities. And in the higher planetary system, the standard of living may be very, not maybe it is mentioned, thousands and thousands of times better than this planet. This is called Bhuloka, then Bhuvarloka, then Sarvaloka, Janaloka, Mahaloka, Tapaloka, Satyaloka, Brahmaloka. These are different higher planetary systems. And each loka, the standard of happiness, is thousand times better than the other. This is the truth. And Krishna says, Avarna Bhuvana Loka. And similarly down, there are different lokas, tall, akal, talatal, nital, patal, like that. This is the constitution. But here, Rishabdev said, say anywhere you go, the threefold miseries of material existence, that will continue. You cannot get rid of it. Even Brahmaloka, the Brahma, he is subjected to death. He also undergo the principles of death, and what to speak of others. Nobody will exist here. Abrahma Pupanalukan Puravartinatura. So we should know that we are trying to improve our material condition. It doesn't matter. You are now a poor man, and by doing something you get, I mean, a great amount of wealth. That does not mean that we're free from dangerous condition of life. That is not. Sarvata. Either in this planet or another planet or to this condition, that condition, the threefold miseries, adhyatmik, adhidaivik, adhidaivik, and adhibhauti, these miseries and janma mitra jarabhyasi, Krishna says, janma mitra jarabhyasi, dukkha dosham darsana. Krishna never says that within this universe, if you go to the heavenly planet, then you can avoid janma mitra jarabhyasi. Never says. Nobody says. Krishna says, even if you go to the heavenly planet, avrahma bhuvan loka, the janma mitra jarabhyasi, there it is. You cannot avoid. Jagatyana nivartante tad dhamam paramam mama. But if you come to me, Paramdham, then you can unite. Dukkhalayam asasvatam. Here, everywhere, you find Dukkhalayam asasvatam. Just I was reading last night that Brihaspati's wife is kidnapped by Chandra. The Brihaspati is the spiritual master of the demigods, and his wife was kidnapped by Chandra. He is also one of the demigods. Just see, the sex and lusty desires are so strong even in the higher planetary system. And that is the cause. That is the cause. Here it is said, lingam vapohit kusalo homakhyam. This false ego is the cause of our miserable condition in this material world. Material world is miserable. Dukkhalayam asasatam. This material world. One ant is living, say, for one day, and I am living for 100 years, and Brahma is living for millions of years. That does not mean any one of us is free from the miserable condition of this material. Nobody. This material world is called Dukkhalayam Asasvatam. Mam Peta Kauntya Dukkhalayam Asasvatam Nabhuvanti Mahatmanam Samsiddhim Paramatmata. That is Samsiddhi, that if you become able how to become free from this encasement of material body. Lingam Bapo, there was the endeavor should be how to give up this material body and be situated in our spiritual status, and that will give us. So for that, there are so many practices, regulative principles mentioned here. The first thing is, Hamse Guru Mai Bhaktanu Mritya. This is Adho Gurbhasana. If you do not get a qualified guru, then everything is bogus. If you, by good fortune, if you get the association of a guru, qualified paramahansa guru means sannyasi's last stage is paramahansa. Kutichav, Bahujav, Paribrajaka Acharya and Paramahansa. These are the different stages. When one takes sannyas, he lives outside the village in a kuti, in a cottage, and the family members goes and delivers him the food because he is not practiced. So in the beginning, he keeps up this association of neighborhood or family, but he is not practiced. He therefore lives outside the village, and if somebody gives some food, he eats. Then when he becomes experienced, then he does not accept food from one, either his own home or one home. He takes foodstuff from many homes. Give me a little piece of chapati. So, somebody gives half, because they are also not overburdened. If they have to deliver so many sannyasis, come, and sumptuous food, then how is Jesus going to provide? Therefore, though they do not overburden, there may be other sannyasis, therefore little on it. Madhupuri, the Goswamis practice this Madhupuri in Vrindavan. They live, but they will take little only from the household. This is called Bahuga. Then when he practices more, he travels all over the world. Paribrajaka-acharya. And when he is fully experienced, then in spiritual life and everything, then he is Paramahamsa. So one must find out a guru who is Paramahamsa. Neither Kutichap nor Bahujap nor Kutbrah. Paramahamsa. So in the Chaitanya Charitamrita also, Lord Chaitanya says, Guru Krishna Kripaya Paya Bhakti Lata Bij. This Bhakti Lata Bij can be obtained through the mercy of Guru and Krishna. Here, Rishabdev is incarnation of Krishna. Therefore, he says, Mai, Hamse Guru Mai. You cannot jump over Krishna. I know Krishna. I shall go to Krishna directly without Guru. There are many rascals, they say like that. No, that is not possible. First of all, Guru, then Krishna. Hamse Guru Mai. Bhaktanu Mritya. So these are descriptions. This is the beginning. If we actually practice the description and the prescription given in the Shastra, then it will be possible that, as it is said, karmanubhadya dirha asrathita, then our strong desire to enjoy this material world in different way, that will be slack. That is not. Thank you.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 16, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. recorded on the 4th of November, 1976, in Vrindavan, India.
Lokasyam Sreyasi Nastadishti Jo Arthan Samihita Nikama Kama Ananna Vaira Sukalesa Hetu Rananta Dukhamcha Nabhidam Vira. This is the description of the material world. Ananna Vaira, simply envious of one another. This is material. I am envious of you, you are envious of me. You can extend this family-wise, society-wise, community-wise, national-wise, but the basic principle is enviousness, nothing. Therefore, in the beginning of the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is explained that who are fit for accepting this Bhagavat principle? Dharma prudhita koitavatra paramanirmasaranam. This is meant for the persons who are no more envious. For them, those who are envious, they have no entrance in the principles of Srimad Bhagavatam. Paramanirmas, because the whole world is based on the principle of enviousness. Ananna Vaira. And what is the meaning of this enviousness? Sukhalesa hetu, temporary happiness. Temporary happiness. Now, especially the modern world, not only modern world, always that is the nature of this material world, how much fighting is going on between nation to nation, person to person, community to community. There are so many courts, legal courts. The people go there, fight with one another. Then the United Nations, what is that United Nations? I have already explained many times. Assembly of Barking Dogs, that's all. United. They will never unite